As a supplier to the entertainment industry, we've obviously been rallying behind the Association of Lighting Directors Safe Stage Lighting campaign. Both Tim Routledge and Richard Pilbrow, letters, the 30th of April and the 1st of May, have articulated excellently how disastrous the proposed EU lighting regulations would be for lighting designers in theater and concert touring. However, this goes far beyond the entertainment industry. Alongside theaters, we supply the same endangered lighting technology to a range of events and installations. These include fashion shows, car launches, corporate events, exhibitions and visitor attractions such as the recent Pink Floyd exhibition at the V. All these events use equipment that could potentially be banned from 2020, with no viable alternative available. Imagine what these will look like when illuminated by industrial-style lighting. There are also the ramifications on the people whose livelihoods this will directly impact. The diverse nature of the industry makes it hard to put a number to the jobs at risk, but it is several thousand in the UK alone. So, while this is about the lights going out on stages, in stadiums and on catwalks across the world, it's also about the impact it has at the grassroots level, which is why we cannot allow these EU regulations to go through. There are thousands of schools, halls, community centres, village halls and small theatres that have small lighting rigs that cost a few hundred pounds per year to maintain. These venues will need to find tens of thousands of pounds to replace their equipment while scrapping the perfectly working kit. Most of these venues will therefore have to stop holding live events. I would encourage readers to help. Brian Raven, Managing Director, White Light Limited, or the EU Environmental Proposals for Stage Lighting, the beginning of the end for live music. Legitimate concerns don't always justify rushed conclusions, and some of the industry's arguments need clarifying. The rules in question are part of the Eco Design Directive, which gradually removes from the market the most damaging products for the environment and the people. While similar rules already apply to some energy-related products, the European Commission is conducting a study to assess their feasibility for all lighting sources. If the study concludes that the impact of the proposed rules may undermine the industry, EU officials can amend the proposal. An exemption for stage lighting, which is what the industry is demanding, could then be a viable option. But an evidence-based assessment is needed in order to identify solutions that are in the interest of both citizens and the industry. For example, allowing the entertainment industry to continue using current stage lighting would make sense. Rules are needed to prevent similar energy-guzzling lights from being used improperly to, say, light your garden at night. Depending on the outcome of the assessment, a compromise could be to have energy labels on all stage lighting instead. A label would pull consumers towards the best products by giving them an impartial AG ranking. All in all, energy efficiency requirements are the kind of plain, common-sense tool that the EU can be proud of. If we are to address some of the world's most pressing challenges, we need both political willingness and common sense. To all music fans, don't worry, the show will go on. Stefan Ardida, European Environmental Bureau, is trustees of the charity LightAware. We read with interest the letter from Richard Pilbrow. We wholeheartedly support the Save Stage Lighting campaign. We would also like to alert readers to the fact that this mistaken legislation goes far beyond theater, and constitutes a crisis not just in the arts but also in health and social justice. Legislation banning incandescent lighting has created a severe situation of social exclusion for those who cannot tolerate new forms of lighting, including LED and fluorescent lighting, and this tightening of the legislation means even fewer alternatives. We hear from light-sensitive people throughout the UK and around the world who are struggling to work, participate in leisure activities, travel, study or even access the streets at night because of the recent changes in lighting. We believe that it is immoral to ban a form of lighting with no provision for those who cannot tolerate the alternatives to light their homes and live their lives. John Lincoln and Eleanor Levin, LightAware trustees. I fully endorse Richard Pilbrow's comments. If the proposed EU regulation is not amended to exempt theatres from these strictures, the only viable indoor theatre in the country would probably be the candlelit Sam Wanamaker Playhouse. Chris Newald, Questers Theatre, London. Join the debate via email guardian.letters@theguardian.com. Read more Guardian letters, click here to visit goo.com/letters.